Welcome to my class. Psalms 37 verse 5, commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in Him, and He shall bring it to pass. God bless us all. Keep safe and enjoy learning. Good day, everyone. Our lesson for today is the fourth kingdom, the kingdom Protista. Yesterday, we talked about the kingdom Monera, the kingdom of bacteria. In bacteria, we have the helpful bacteria and the harmful bacteria. Now, today, we will discuss about the kingdom Protista. Kingdom Protista, like Monerans, protists are also microscopic and single-celled organisms. But remember, they differ greatly in body structures. Protists have a true nuclei and other cell parts. Most protists reproduce by fission. Others reproduce or produce by conjugation, a form of sexual reproduction. Always remember that. So we have two types of organisms. We have the plant-like protists that can produce their own food, and the animal-like protists that cannot make their own food but instead capture their own food. So always remember, we have the two types of organisms, the plant-like protist and the animal-like protist. Kingdom Protista usually reproduce asexually by fission. Always remember that. Sexually by means of fission. In some species, a type of sexual reproduction does occur. Some protists are source of food and oxygen for the pond or for the other pond organisms, while others can cause disease in people and some animals. So, first, we have the plant-like protists that can produce their own food. Plant-like protists that can produce their own food. Euglena, dinoflagellates, and diatoms are example of protists with chlorophyll. Remember, Euglena, dinoflagellates, and diatoms, they are the protists that has a chlorophyll. Because of this, they can manufacture their own food. Okay po? Protists that has chlorophyll can produce or can manufacture their own food. First one, we have the Euglena. Euglena has the animal features. When Euglena lives in darkness, it loses its green pigment and takes its food from the surroundings, just like animals. That is its animal features. So when Euglena lives in darkness, it loses its green pigment and takes food from the surroundings. Next, we have the dinoflagellates. Dinoflagellates, also called the fire algae. Why it is called the fire algae? It is because they sometimes look like fire in water. Aside from the green pigment, other species also contain the red pigment. That red pigment produces poison that can kill many sea animals. Did you hear the word red tide? Red tide happens when the red pigment of dinoflagellates increases in numbers. That's why some sea animals, especially fishes that man eat, died. Okay? When the red pigment of dinoflagellates increase in numbers, it causes the red tide and it can kill many sea animals. That is the disadvantage of dinoflagellates. Third one is the diatoms. Diatoms, also called the golden algae. Their cell walls are glass-like shells. If you can see at the picture at your screen, it is a glass-like shells. They appear in different shapes such as circular, triangular, rectangular, and other shapes. So that is the diatoms. The special features of this is glass-like shells. Second one is the animal-like that do not manufacture their own food. Animal-like that do not manufacture their own food. Okay, protozoans are the protists that have the animal characteristics. Remember, protozoans are the protists that have the animal characteristics. They made up of a single cell without cell walls. Protozoans cannot manufacture their own food because they do not have the chlorophyll. They eat other living things for food. Remember, protozoans do not have a chlorophyll. That's why they cannot manufacture their own food. Most of them live in oceans, fresh waters, and moist soil. Protozoans are grouped into four according to the way they move. Remember, protozoans group into four according to the way they move. Number one is the ciliates. Ciliates are the protozoans that move by means of cilia. You can look at the picture at your screen. It is an example of ciliates. The short-like hair parts extending from the cell. That is the cilia. Paramecium is a well-known example of ciliates. Remember, ciliates move by means of cilia. The second one is the flagellates. Flagellates move by means of flagella. Flagella. Many of them are parasites in animals. They live in the intestines of people, termites, or other animals. Some species live in salt water or fresh water. Most of the flagellates cause disease. These protozoans is transmitted by a tsetse flies. A tsetse flies is used to transmit protozoans to another animals or any objects that can live the flagellates. Okay, flagellates, remember, move by means of flagella. The third one does not have any specialized way of moving. This is the sporozoans. Sporozoans, they are all parasites that live inside the bodies of other organisms. When the condition is unfavorable, they can form resting cells for protection. Many sporozoans cause disease in man and animals. So, best example of disease that causes by protozoans is malaria. Malaria is a disease caused by a protozoans that is transmitted by mosquitoes. So, when mosquitoes bite our skin, it can transmit protozoans that can cause malaria. Okay? Not just the dengue, the well-known dengue. Okay? Remember that. So, be aware of the mosquitoes. The last one is the sarcodines. Sarcodines use pseudopods to move and to get their own food. Remember, sarcodines use pseudopods to move and to get their food. Pseudopods means false foot. False foot. Some species are covered by a hard shells. When sarcodines die, their shells fall to the bottom of the water where they live. Limestone and chalk are made up of the sarcodine's shell. Can you imagine that? Amoebas are common sarcodines. Can you imagine that limestones and chalks are made up of sarcodines? That is an amazing creation of our Lord. So, remember, sarcodines use pseudopods to move to get their food. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you learned something today. God bless you all. Goodbye.